third type you write down, the third type of conjugated system is pi sigma and free radical. Pi sigma and free radical. One electron, right? One dot means one single electron. Example of this is CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH2 and free radical only. Okay, so in this we draw the resonating is like this. So this pi electron, one electron comes over here, it is in half arrow because one homolysis it is. One electron is taken up by this carbon, another electron is taken up by this carbon. Okay, and this free radical combines, forms a double bond, and the structure is CH2 radical CH double bond CH2. Got it? RS. How many RS possible here?
Two.
So then.
Right. Three. RS possible.
So what's the definition of free radical?
Free radical is any carbon atom which has three bond pair and one unpaired electron. Okay. Unpaired electron, so its number of electron is what? Seven. Seven electrons. But it is not, it is electron deficient, but not, but cannot behave as a Lewis acid because more than eight electron is not possible. If you have, if you remove this electron also, it becomes carbocation. Right? If you have one electron radical, add one more electron, it becomes a carbonyl. So it is an intermediate which forms during the process of a reaction. Generally, free radical forms in those reactions where we have, we use sunlight, H nu. Okay, then carbon-carbon bonds, homolysis takes place. Homolysis means when you have a carbon-carbon bond, so it has two electron on it. Homolysis and heterolysis, two types of bond cleavage we have, right? So one heterolysis is when the two bond pair is taken up by only one carbon atom, okay? So C negative, C positive, like this, which is in this case not possible because one of the atom must be more electronegative. Like suppose we have carbon and chlorine bond, carbon halogen bond. Chlorine is more electronegative. This bond pair is taken up by this chlorine and it forms C plus a carbocation and Cl minus. Okay, so this is heterolysis. Now when you break this bond, homolysis, one electron is taken up by this carbon, one by this carbon. So this forms a radical like this, carbon-carbon radical. And it is possible when you use sunlight generally. Okay. So free radical is what? Free radical is, it is an intermediate which has three bond pair and one unpaired electron, paramagnetic in nature. Got it? Type 4 we have pi sigma pi. This is type 4. Okay? Alternate pi bond. CH2 double bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. Its RS is what? This pi electron comes over here and this pi electron on this carbon. So we get CH2 positive charge, CH double bond, CH2, CH2 negative charge. This is the RS.
So this is gonna have a lesser
stability.
Yeah.
In comparison to this? No, if you compare the stability of these two, right? If you compare the stability of these two, this one is more stable. Two pi bonds. But while reaction, it won't give reactions with this. The addition takes place this carbon and that carbon. We'll discuss that in alkene chapter. Okay? Reaction of HX on alkene. Okay? It gives conjugated dienes. It is. What is the name of this compound? 1,3. butadiene.
Oh,
1,3 butadiene, okay? So 1,3 butadiene gives you 1,4 addition, not 1,2 addition. Reason we'll discuss in alkene, okay? This is the type 4 system we have. What about this one? In this, do we have resonance possible? Do we have ions possible in this?
Sir, third one is not possible.
It's not possible. Why?
It's possible.
Pi sigma pi.
So how do you know if something is planar?
All carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized.
So in that one,
check out the
no.
So sp2 means
sp3.
This diagram planar is geometry. No, it will be in the same plane. Carbon 3 bond in the same plane. Pyramidal is like this. Pyramidal when you put the carbon like this. But in the same plane, triangular planar. So it is planar. Sorry,
that's type 4.
Type 4, yes.
So should we form another one which has double single double?
Where?
Is it that resonance, the other structure also should have double single words, double
in this is not possible. One is but if you have further conjugation this side, then also it is possible, I suppose.
So this is also still resonance.
See, resonating is such you can draw till conjugation is there. Like I effect me what we say, it is distance dependent effect because sigma electrons are involved. Here distance factor is not there, but it requires only conjugation. So in the molecule we can draw resonating structure till conjugation is there. Like here you see, this part is not in conjugation, sp3 hybridized. So we can draw resonating structure of this one from this carbon to this carbon. This is not involved in resonance, okay? So this resonating structure is what when you draw it, you'll get a double bond here, negative charge here and positive charge. Okay? For this one, if you draw, this pi electron comes over here and this pi electron jumps onto this oxygen. So this CH2, CH, single bond CO minus, H, double bond and positive charge. Can we draw this way? This pi electron comes over here and this pi electron comes over here. Reverse.
So how do you know which one becomes positive and which one becomes
positive?
That's what I am asking. Can we draw this way? This comes over here, this comes over here. You can draw. Draw kar name kya hai? Draw kar to.
Even in the second one.
Yes, that will be a different resonating structure. But that is the least not stable at all. Because you see, oxygen is more electronegative. So it has tendency to attract electron. That's why the best way to draw the RS is the shifting of electron towards oxygen.
So
not away from it.
So even the second one also you can have like,
so
the other way around.
So we can't have positive charge on electronegative atom, right?
That's what, see, you can draw any structure. Whether it is stable or not, that is a different debate. But whether you can draw it or not, you can draw it.
But is it a resonance?
But usually what we say, usually we'll draw the structure and we shift the electron towards the more electronegative.
Second one, sir. You can have more, right? Double bond, single bond, positive. That's type one, right? We can conjugate that also.
Yeah.
Where?
No. That will go back to the same.
See, what you can do, you can do one thing. This comes over here, and this comes over here. This gives you the same. अरे जो भी करना है कर लो, यू विल गेट दिस ओनली. ड्रॉ करके देखो. सी व्हाट यू कैन डू, यू कैन शिफ्ट दिस हियर. ठीक है सो विल हैव अ डबल बॉन्ड हियर. हां 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 एंड दिस इज पॉजिटिव चार्ज.
या
दिस पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव मेक्स अ बॉन्ड.
ओह
कार्बन एडजेसेंट कार्बन पे पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव चार्ज इज नेवर स्टेबल. वो हो ही नहीं सकता है. कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड इफ यू हैव, यू सी दिस carbon-carbon double bond, if you want to change this structure into this, C single bond, C positive, negative like this, for this you have to break this pi bond, correct? And for to break this pi bond, you have to provide a lot of energy, right? So this is the higher energy molecule on
the positive.
That you can do. It's the same thing. That you can do. No, it's not different. If you draw, if you, let's say, same thing. Understood this?
So is that a resonating structure when minus is on there and plus is on there?
Generally, we don't consider that. But if they ask you to draw, you have to draw. Shifting of electron, you can do, molecule won't do. So, molecule though, automatic the shifting of electron takes. So, we are not, see, benzene if you are taking, right? We are trying to study the structure of benzene by shifting the electron. But when benzene exists, the electron is already delocalized in its own way. So, when you draw, if you want to draw, you can draw it this way, reverse. But what molecule will do? Oxygen takes electron. It goes this way. Means you can draw, but molecule won't do that. That's why that structure you won't come. Okay, understood this. Now, apart from this four, these four, there are two more conjugated system possible, which is not that important. I'll just write down the type. Type 5 and type 6, you write down. Type 5, we have a vacant orbital, P, sigma bond, and a lone pair. Vacant orbital, sigma and lone pair. Okay? And type 6 we have a lone pair, p orbital lone pair, sigma and vacant d. Vacant d and lone pair. One example we have already done, PF3. It's lone pair in P orbital. Lone pair in P orbital, sigma bond, vacant D. Okay? Vacant P, sigma bond, lone pair. Example is this. Boron has vacant P orbital, we know this, 3 bond, vacant P, and fluorine has lone pair on it. So back bonding is possible. This is back bonding. It has double bond characteristics. It has pi bond correct, not double bond, pi bond characteristics. Which forms when the sigma bond has been formed. After that, the central atom, if it has vacant orbital, and the other atom has the lone pair, and if size is comparable, then this has tendency to donate electron. That is back bond. Sigma bond form hone ke baad, tendency to donate electron is back bond. Okay? But that BCl3, that bonding is not that strong. Because chlorine may will have 3p orbital. And here we have 2p. 2p, 3p ka overlap is not that great. For bromine also, it is even lesser stable the bond. For BF3, the back bonding is strongest. Out of
so, why is this different from vacant?
Where we have vacant?
Like this is vacant P, but we had another one.
We didn't have the vacant
P. Vacant P.
In the first one, there was the lone pair.
Yes. Got it? Vacant D, the example is this. We have CH2. Lone pair on it, single bond Cl, right? Chlorine is the element of third period, right? So it has vacant orbital, vacant d orbital. So in this the resonance is possible. CH2 double bond, Cl, negative, here we have positive. Not that important, but in this case, positive. That's all these are the six different types of conjugated system where the resonance is possible.